Tuesday night, and we've got live baseball on MLB Network as we're at Chase Field in Phoenix. Tonight, the second of three to start the week between the Miami Marlins and the Arizona Diamondbacks. Major League Baseball on MLB Network coming up right after this. Taijuan Walker is on the mound for the Diamondbacks. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
You know, Matt, he wasn't all that bad in his last one. In a day and age where we don't see a lot of complete games, six full innings in his last one, and if they can score him a few runs, he has a chance to win this one here today.
So striding in, number 47. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. The 2-1 home. Hit in the air down the right field line. But this will land untouched. 73 degrees our game time temperature here tonight, and it probably won't get a whole lot cooler than that. Here now the 2-2. And another foul ball. Here now the 2-2. Doesn't get the zone. Okay. Count full now.
Boy, not what you want coming out of the gate as a pitcher, right? You don't want to have to show all of your pitches this early on in the game, but that's a quality at bat. And what does it make you do as a pitcher? You have to use a lot of your pitches, and the more pitches a hitter sees, the better chance they have to make good contact.
Hard hit ball to second. Flores is there. Throws in time, and that's at number one. And here's how the visiting Miami Marlins will line up in this one. Dan Plesac, who are you focused on?
Yeah, you know, I love what the Grandy man, Curtis Granderson, does for this ball club. He's really had a heck of a year in the power categories, slugging over 500 coming into this one. That means almost every time he's hitting the ball, he's hitting it hard somewhere. Should be fun to watch.
Up next from Miami, Miguel Rojas. And as you check out his righty-lefty splits, no surprise that he hits better against southpaws than he does against right-handers. And now a pitch on the way. Popped him up. And he'll lunge out of the crouch to make the play for out number two. And that'll bring in Garrett Cooper. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. Walker steps into his windup, looking to put him away here on a ball and two strikes. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. And set up behind the dish is Clyde Washington, as you see the rest of our umpiring crew there.
You know, D-Row, he is a pitcher's best friend, Clyde Washington. Down in the strike zone, he'll definitely call that ball right at the knees.
If he's consistent with it, Dan, which Clyde always is, I'm okay with it.
And here's Flores to make the catch, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Marlins. And now the Diamondbacks will get their first turn at it. No score. Jose Arena, a right-handed native of the Dominican Republic, will be the starter. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, Matt, we're getting a look at a guy that's really been struggling lately. In his last three starts, he has a whip of over 1.50. Lots of base runners, lots of hits, and lots of walks, and that doesn't add up to very good performances. So he's going to look to turn things around in this one here today.
Standing in, Wilmer Flores. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. And the fastball easy to lay off that time, 2-2. Scorched to third. Castro's got it. And he's retired one away. With that, let's take a look at the hometown Diamondbacks lineup card. Dan, who do we keep an eye on?
Well, there are very few guys that can do what Adam Jones can do for a team. He's one of those guys you want at the plate in those big game-defining moments. He's such a clutch hitter. I love watching him in those situations, and hopefully we'll have that in this game as well.
Up next for Arizona, Adam Jones, head-to-head with Jose Urena, batting at an even 400. He also has one home run. A ball and two strikes to Adam Jones.
Not too often you see a changeup come across at 88 miles an hour on the gun. Still effective when you're throwing a fastball in the high 90s, though.
Just hung in there on that one. And he takes very close to the inside corner here. 2-2, though.
Well, I think that's a great spot for that pitch. In on the hands. It wasn't a strike, but if he can command the movement in there, he's going to be very effective in this one.
Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. And this is popped up near second base. And there's at number two. So stepping in, David Peralta. Couple of hits for him in four trips to the plate last night. The 1-1. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul. So a missed opportunity there. Ready on 1-2. Swing and a drive to right by Peralta. This one's got some carry. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. And now he'll get into scoring position with two away. So here's the cleanup hitter for Arizona, Ketel Marte. He's looking to get things going at the plate. It has not been going his way of late. Peralta at second with two down. Checks his swing here, but he does so in time. Guys, this Marlins ball club, as they begin play here tonight, they come off another loss last time out, and in fact, they've dropped three of their last four.
Yeah, Maddie, this road trip's been a little bit of a struggle for this team. First four games, they find themselves 1-3, haven't played particularly well. They'll find a way to regroup. They have to find a way to play a little bit more fundamentally sound.
Well, the play's been made, and that retires the side. Danger averted following the two-out double. An inning in the books. No score on MLB Network. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Jorge Alfaro. And he's looking to snap out of what's been a rather dry spell at the plate. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
Okay, here's how the snakes are lining up defensively. And let's take a look at David Peralta. Bazooka arm in the outfield. Obviously, he was originally signed as a pitcher. Didn't work out. Reset the battery and came back as a big league outfielder. Impressive.
Into the box, number one. He brings a rather ugly 230s batting average into this one. Back up the middle. Scooped up on the backhand. And that's the second out. Ready now for the Marlins, Starlin Castro. And as you take a look at the splits here, he's actually better against right-handed pitching this season. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball. Well, guys, you take a look at this Diamondback squad as they begin play here tonight. They come in looking to make it two in a row as they were winners last time out.
Yeah, Matty B, we're looking at a team right now. They're just playing some average baseball through four games of this homestand. They split it 2-2, D-Row, and I think they expect a little bit more.
Yeah, and you don't want to be playing average baseball in front of your home fans. They need to find a way to win this game and try and take three out of the first five of this homestand.
You know, it takes a lot of discipline to watch a pitch like that go by, but on a 3-1 count, he had the luxury of being a little bit more selective up there. Good take and a walk is the result.
Stepping into the box, Curtis Granderson. He's been feeling pretty good about things recently as you see the numbers over his past 10 contests. The 1-2. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Walker comes set. Here's the 1-2. He jumps on this one. It's high and deep to center. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. One left for Miami. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Ready now for the Diamondbacks. Christian Walker comes off an 0-for-4 in last night's ball game. Now a ball pulled hard but fouled off to the left.
He wasn't fooling anybody with that fastball. He barreled it up nice right there. He's just got to find a way to keep it fair.
The 1-2. Misses, ball two. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Check out the Miami Marlins on defense. And let's take a look at Curtis Granderson. He stood the test of time. Former center fielder, can play both corners as well, known for picking him up and putting him down. This guy can go get him in the gaps.
Stepping in, Jake Lamb. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Bottom of the second here with no score. High in the air out to center field. Center fielder has a beat on it. He's got it, and there are two down now. Eduardo Escobar standing in. He did not play last night, but clearly back in the starting nine for this one. 1-1, here it comes.
Nope.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. On the year, Escobar is slugging a little under the 400 mark, so the chances of his connecting with the ball right here aren't particularly good.
Here we go.
Pop foul, and it looks like that's going to make it into the VIP seats. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Just missed with the 2-2 count, and it runs full now. Two out, nobody on. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Scooped up. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Nothing doing here this half. We'll go now to the top of the third, and we are tied nothing-nothing. Now at the plate, number 48. He was a perfect 4-for-4 in last night's game.
Come on now, get a K right here.
Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Inside for a ball as he falls behind to him here, 3-1.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
Three and two.
Three balls. Two strikes.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Jones is under it. He's got it one away. And with that, there you get a look at what's happening in the race in the National League West. Now to the plate, the pitcher, Jose Arena, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Third inning, no score to this point. A ball and two strikes to the Marlins pitcher. And strike three called on the outside corner. He's earned the right to live out there with the fastballs, as that's out number two. Now at the plate, number 47, 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Flip. Takes this the other way to right, and the Marlins had their first hit of the game.
Boy, Dero, the game of baseball has changed. There's so much velocity in the game. That was a 96-mile-an-hour fastball that he smoked the other way.
Yeah, you have to keep your front shoulder tucked right there. You have to honor. When a guy's throwing that hard, 96 miles an hour, you have to honor that fastball and try and work it the other way to keep you on the off speed.
In now, Miguel Rojas. And it's 1-2. The 1-2. Popped him up. Escobar is there for it. And that's the third out. Marlins leave one. Home half of the third coming up. No score. At the plate, Carson Kelly, as we move on to the bottom of inning number three. Hit on the ground to third. Castro has it. And there's one down now. Coming to the plate now, the pitcher for the Diamondbacks, Taiwan Walker. The 1-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
Hey, that's a really good pitch right there. And that's one of those off-balance swings. As a pitcher, you want to look in and say, howdy, if you're waving at me. A real ugly swing, and it gives you a lot of confidence when you make a guy look that bad. So hopefully he has another pitch left in his repertoire to bury this guy and get him out of there.
Here now the 2-2. He stays alive, still 2-2. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Granderson is under it. Two down. Striding in, Wilmer Flores. 0 for 1 here in the early going. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. That one finds the target on the outer half. It's 1-2. Bottom of inning number three, nothing our score. The slider freezes him at the plate. A called third strike, and the inning comes to a close. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. Ready for another chance? Garrett Cooper comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings with no score. You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some base runners on and get him in, but that hasn't been the case.
And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Still all zeros in the run column here in the fourth inning. Dan, does this continue, or does somebody score here?
I think this continues for a while, Matt. Both of these pitchers are throwing very well, throwing strikes, having good command of their off-speed pitches. This is going to be one of those low-scoring affairs.
He's ready. Now the payoff pitch. And he lays off there, ball four. So the leadoff man is on here to begin stanza number four.
Well, they haven't been able to scratch a run across yet, so maybe this walk will jumpstart their offense a little bit.
So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Jorge Alfaro. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. The 2-1. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Just one hit apiece for both of these clubs. Into center field, line drive, base hit. Not every day that you see a ball come off the bat like that one did, and looking at it again on show track, we see it a lot faster than it came in. 113 miles an hour. Couldn't have hit that one much better than that. Into the box now, number one. And the pitch misses low and away for ball two.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be aggressive. You can pretty much count on a pitcher. He's trying to get back in the strike zone. And with two guys on base right here, it's time to grip it and rip it.
Fouled off. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now. There's Starlin Castro. He'll follow next. Cooper over at second. Alfaro on at first with nobody out. And this one misses here. A close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it ball four.
And things are not looking good here in the fourth inning. That's the second walk of the frame. Good time for the catcher to go out to the mound and have a chat with this guy to give him a little breather.
Striding in once again, Starlin Castro. He drew a walk his first time up. Needs a punch out here. Can he get it? Yes, he can. Strike three called, and that's a big out number one.
I'm really impressed by that strikeout, and I'll tell you why. He should have gotten the call on the pitch before, and it looked like he got squeezed a little bit. In a bases-loaded situation, that can drive a guy nuts, drive you crazy. What I loved is he didn't let him take it out of his game, and he came back with another good pitch and got the punch out. A really nice job of taking it one pitch at a time.
Ball three. 3-2 now.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number four. And that misses. Ball four. A run will come in to score.
And this inning is a perfect example of how quickly fortunes can change in this game. He was cruising along, hardly any trouble at all. Now he walks in a run and is still in the middle of a bases-loaded mess. He's got some work to do to limit the damage.
Settling in now, number 48. He's got the bases loaded now and a chance to really do some damage.
And he's one of those guys that they really rely on to come through in spots like this, Matt. Second on the team and runs batted in.
No
He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Well, when the pressure starts to intensify, it often feels like the strike zone gets harder and harder to hit. This is a big spot here.
He's set. Here's the 3-1. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Peralta's after it. Makes the catch, but the runner from third breaks for home. And they'll extend their lead even further as the run from third is in to score.
Obviously, he's hoping for more up there with the bases loaded, but you can't be too upset with the sac fly.
Coming to the plate now, the pitcher for the Marlins, Jose Arena, and a chance now to increase his lead if he can deliver something here with two gone. Coming up now on 30 pitches in the inning. And this is swung on and missed as the 30th pitch of this inning finally does the trick. The side is retired. So it's two runs on just one base hit, no errors, and two men left on base. On now to the bottom half of inning number four. It's the Marlins 2 and the Diamondbacks nothing. Back alongside Mark DeRozan, Dan Plesac, Matt Vasgersian as Adam Jones gets set to start out the inning. Into his motion, here comes the 3-1. Tried to crush that ball and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. The 3-2 pitch. And that misses for ball four. It's a leadoff walk that starts the bottom of the fourth.
This is only their second base runner of the game after that earlier hit. Tough to score when you don't have anyone on base, so we'll see if they can get something going here.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, David Peralta, 1-for-1 as he reached base with a double his first time up.
Yeah, give me a repeat performance of that last double. With a man on first right now, let him run, get you a ribbon.
Off the plate that time and a little high, it's even at 2-2. Fastball is outside and it's full now, 3-2.
Not what you want to do on the mound, go from 0-2 to 3-2, but credit the man in the box for being patient, even with two strikes.
No runs, just one hit. No errors so far for the Diamondbacks. And he lays off there, ball four. So back-to-back walks have him in business here with nobody out.
Well, they've struggled offensively in this one so far, but after that walk, they've got runners at first and second and look ready to make a little noise. Just need a big hit now.
Digging in the switch hitter, Ketel Marte. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And that nearly would have gotten him on the board. Instead, it's a long foul ball. Here's the pitch on 2-2. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's out number one.
Well, his struggles continue. It's been a rough go of it at the plate with him, and watching this at bat, it's clear to me that his rhythm and timing, they're just all off. Even as a pitcher like I was, you can tell these things and exploit them.
Into the box, Christian Walker. And he takes a called strike two. Jones on second. Peralta is over at first with one away. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. Jake Lamb waits on deck. Working for the punch out and the offering. Hard hit ball to second, and that's through for a base hit. And they'll hold that runner at third as everybody moves up a base, and they're loaded with one away.
I know this guy isn't known for his hitting prowess, but that's a nice job right there. Getting a single on a 3-2 pitch in the middle of the zone, grab your glove and flash some leather.
Stepping in now, Jake Lamb. On the ground to second base, this could be two. One there, relay to first in time, and just like that, this side is retired. A couple of walks, but no damage. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. So the lineup flips over and digging in, number 47. 1-for-2 on his line so far in the game. Ready to deal. Here's the 2-1. Ball three.
Well, that's ball three, and the Marlins right now would do anything to get a leadoff walk to get this inning started.
The 3-1. Popped him up. And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number one. Now batting, Miguel Rojas. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. And here's a ball hit in the air. Jones on the move, but this will land untouched. Slap hard the opposite way, but he'll barely have to move out there in right as he hauls this one in for the second out.
Boy, sometimes they say you hit it hard, good things will happen. Well, that's not the case right there. That was a bullet that just stayed up and is caught in the outfield.
In now, Garrett Cooper. And this is taken for a called strike. Oh, that's a tough call. Now 1-2.
That's the ball.
That misses, and we're even at 2-2.
Let's go. Shut him down.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. And that'll get down out there near the wall. And he is in the second with a two-out double.
That base hit was screaming off the bat, and our show track technology more than confirms it. 111 miles an hour was the exit velocity of that line drive.
Standing in now, Jorge Alfaro. A little bit outside, 2-1. And now some action in that Arizona bullpen as it looks like they'll have both a lefty and a righty up to throw. Fouled away. Cooper stands at second with two gone. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. One left for Miami, but they're on top 2-0. And back in Phoenix as we check in with Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the commercial break, I had a chance to catch up with manager Torey Lovello about the Diamondbacks' offensive production. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. No, they have not scored yet, but they have been successful in running up the pitch count, something they feel will eventually pay dividends on the scoreboard as the starter gets tired and they are forced to go to the bullpen. For now, they're sticking to the plan.
Thank you, Heidi. Stepping into the box, Eduardo Escobar. He'll start things out here in the home fifth, and it's been tough sledding for this lineup through the first half of the game.
Yeah, they haven't had any momentum going to the plate so far in this one, Matt. They need something to break their way and wake them up a bit.
Be nice to get these fans involved at some point as well. The 1-1. Popped him up. Alfaro moving to his left, and that's the first out of the inning. Digging in, Carson Kelly. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Bases are empty, one man out. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Three balls and a strike to Carson Kelly. Inside, he misses ball four.
And that hole at bat, I feel like he really didn't want to challenge him. And I'm really surprised by that because I think this is a guy in the bottom third of the order you have to go right after.
Number 26 will be summoned off the bench here as he'll pinch hit with a runner at first and one gone in the inning. Swing and a miss as he ran that two-seamer right by him for the second out.
Really impressive pitching right there. Sometimes as a pitcher you can get frustrated when you make a good pitch and you don't get that call from the umpire, but what does he do? He comes back with a good pitch and gets the strike.
Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in Wilmer Flores. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0 for 2 at this point. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. One left for the Diamondbacks. They're down 2-0. Back now for the start of the sixth inning, and we send it down to Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the commercial break, I had a chance to catch up with manager Don Mattingly about the Marlins' offensive production. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. He said that although they haven't broken through in a big way in the runs column, they have made the opposing pitching work really hard for just about every out. Their starter's pitch count was pretty high, which resulted in him being removed from the game prior to the sixth inning. Now it's a matter of making their bullpen work just as hard, guys.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Number 59 enters from the bullpen to do the pitching. So digging in now, number one. He's 0 for 1 thus far. And it's fouled away. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out.
Boy, there's the perfect pitch right there, the straight changeup. He hadn't used it yet in this at bat, and what does he do? He uses it, pulls the string, and gets the big strikeout.
Into the box, Starlin Castro. This one's down to third. Lamb is up with it. Throw gets him, two down.
In is Curtis Granderson, 0 for 1 with a run batted in thus far. Now the 1-1 pitch. Lifted the other way to left center. Peralta on the move. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Miami down in order as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Coming to the plate now, Adam Jones. He'll start things out in the sixth for a lineup that really hasn't found its groove in this one.
Yeah, only two hits so far, Matt, and not very many hard hit balls either. We'll see if they can start making some adjustments.
Now a fastball swung on and missed, and it's full 3-2.
Oh, man, he took a swing and a half at that one. I think some frustration is creeping into these guys, so he might have just been trying to get his guys on the board with one swing.
And that is swung on and missed by Jones as he becomes out number one.
He's been in total control out there tonight. Gets the leadoff guy with a strikeout there, and it just seems like we've seen so many off-balance swings and weakly hit balls in this one.
Standing in, David Peralta. It was a walk in his last trip. One out, nobody on. And there's ball two now. And now the Marlins bullpen will swing into action as a lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. The 2-1. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Here now the 2-2. Is looked at, and the count moves full.
One of the things you want to do with a starter, get that pitch count up. Here's another productive at-bat, as this count now gets to 3 balls and 2 strikes.
No runs, 2 hits. No errors so far for the Diamondbacks. Lifted down the line and left. In there, a base hit.
Boy, so frustrating as a pitcher. You make a quality pitch on the inside half of the plate right there. Try to bust him in, D-Row, and he fights it off the other way.
Yeah, you tip your hat to the pitcher right there. He executed his pitch, but nice job by the offensive player fighting. It doesn't matter what it looks like. A knock's a knock.
Now the Marlins skipper is up out of the dugout on his way to the mound, and he's looking to the bullpen here, so it would appear that's all for his starter tonight. So as he departs, he'll remain responsible for the man left to board, but he cannot lose this one. Sandy Alcantara enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning. Stepping in now, Ketel Marte to 2-2 now.
In a double play situation, that's the location you want a guy to swing at. More than likely, he's going to beat it into the ground.
The 2-2. Here's a little chopper up the middle to second for one. On to first, but not in time as he's in there ahead of the throw. So that one wasn't quite hit sharply enough to turn two.
Yeah, choppers like that make it really tough. You can't make the ball get to you much faster, so the key is making sure you field it cleanly and at least get one, which they did there.
Digging in and looking for more, Christian Walker. It was a single for him in his last at-bat. 1-1, here it comes. Ball two as the breaking ball misses inside.
Looked like he was trying to work in a front door curveball there, but it seemed like it popped out of his hand a little early, causing it to miss inside.
And he misses badly with a fastball here, and it's 3-1 now.
That's a great call right there. Fastball away with a guy who's got some jets on first base, almost like a hybrid pitch out.
Great for a catcher if that guy's running. Easy transfer throw to second base.
The 3-1. And that misses ball four. So it's first and second now with two out.
He did not want to let the hitter off the hook with two outs. And now he's got a runner in scoring position to deal with.
Adam Conley comes on now, and this move looks to be all about playing the matchup here.
And I think that's exactly the thought process, Matt. He's not as strong of a hitter from the right side, so we'll see if this proves to be a smart move out of the pen.
Jake Lamb will be his first assignment here as he'll face him with runners at first and second and two away. The 1-1 waves and misses for strike number two. Both clubs with three hits in the ballgame.
When you have two strikes on you, as a hitter, if you get something that you can handle, you have to find a way to do some damage with it. That was a missed opportunity.
Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. Another 1-2 delivery. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Diamondbacks strand a pair. They're still down. It's 2-0. Welcome back to Chase Field here in Phoenix. It's on to the seventh inning with the Marlins on top, and it's a good time to check out our game summary through the first six innings of play. Into the box now, number 48. He hit a sac fly earlier. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Yeah, we see a lefty and a right-hander start to loosen up in the bullpen. Now the 2-1. Lifted in the air toward the line and right. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. And they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball three.
Time to focus here. This game is way too close to be walking, guys. So we'll see if he can make him swing the bat on this next pitch.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Still hanging with him. Another good swing to keep it going. The next 3-2. And he fouls this one off. Him up. Under this is Flores, and Wilmer's got it for the first out. Martin Prado will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher. Look out, a fastball up near his dome, and that'll wake you up a bit.
Well, that'll wake everyone up. Anytime you buzz the tower like that, there's reason for people to start getting a little bit edgy.
Line drive to left. And that'll take care of the pinch hitter here for out number two. So the batting order turns over now and set to go number 47. His last at bat didn't go his way as he popped out in foul territory.
Yeah, this one's going to upset him for a little bit. You make the pitcher work the way he did.
Swing, high drive, left field and deep. And it's gone as they add still another. A solo shot here to left. Eighth home run on the season for him as the Marlins have taken a 3-0 lead.
There are certain guys in every lineup that you do not want to beat you. And this guy right now is swinging the bat so well, I'm not giving him a chance to do anything. He's too hot right now.
In now, Miguel Rojas. Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Kelly shading to his right, makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. But the Marlins tack on one more courtesy of the solo home run. Bottom of the seventh inning coming up. Get up and stretch. It's 3-0 Miami. Austin Bryce gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. Coming to the plate now, Eduardo Escobar. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far.
Starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally.
And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Now the 2-1 is a swinging strike, a little late on the fastball that time. The 2-2 doesn't hit the target. It's ball three. Now the 3-2 pitch. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Another full count pitch home. This one's down to third. And the throw by Castro takes care of him for the first out. Stepping in, Carson Kelly. It was a walk in his last trip. Now the pitch. Fastball just inside. Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1.
You know, you don't always have to straight challenge a guy on a 3-2 count. With a three-run lead, no one on base, this is the perfect situation to do it. No reason to nibble and possibly set up a big inning.
Three and two now.
Careful.
And a fastball blew it right by him, and they're two down.
Boy, there's nothing like seeing a good power pitcher that has a good fastball. And what does he do? He just throws this good fastball right by, brings the express. No chance to put that ball in play.
Two and one, the count to Blake Swihart. Swihart, a former Red Sox, he came here by way of trade earlier this year.
I know he tell you he'd like to be playing a little bit better, but I think it's as advertised for this ball club right now. I think the Mets.
There's a swing and a ball hit in the air, and a ball that he got every stitch of, as that one, without a doubt, is gone. A solo shot down the line in right. His first home run of the season. And the Diamondbacks claw back into this one. It's now a 3-1 ball game.
Well, they're still down, but this homer right there might light a fire under the whole team. Give them the spark to climb back into this thing. We'll see if this gets them going.
Into the box now, Wilmer Flores. And he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. Slow roller out to short. Rojas gonna have to hurry. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as this side is retired. One for the Diamondbacks, and it comes courtesy of the long ball. We'll march on to the eighth. It's the Marlins 3 and the D-backs 1. Number 45 will take the ball now as the new pitcher. Striding into the box, Garrett Cooper. He's 1-for-2 in this one. So 1-1 is an off-speed pitch taken for a ball. Now the 2-1 pitch. Swing and a ground ball to third. Backhanded. And an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow. And definitely worth another look with our show track data. Great reaction from the hot corner to make the backhand stop, and then he unleashes that very strong throw while in the air all the way across the diamond. He's going to be smiling about that one. Into the box, Jorge Alfaro. Line towards center field. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. In now, number one. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far. The 1-1. Strike two swinging. Action now in the Arizona bullpen as they have a right-hander up and throwing. Hits are now even at 4 apiece. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Marlins, but they hang on to a 3-1 lead. Ryan Stanek is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Digging in, Adam Jones, 0-for-2 for him to this point.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast, they could certainly use that right now.
The 1-2. This is foul right side. Now another 1-2. And the fastball easy to lay off that time. 2-2. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
And in a two-run game right here, you really don't want to walk the leadoff guy to start an inning. You've got to keep that tying run in the on-deck circle as long as you can.
And this is taken here for ball four. So the leadoff man's on base to kick off the home eight.
Man, that's a tough one to swallow. You're hanging on to a slim lead, and the last thing you want to do is give up a leadoff walk. Seems like those are the ones that always come back to haunt you. So we'll see if that's the case here.
So striding forward now, David Peralta. He doubled earlier and carries a 2-for-2 line into this appearance. Ready to deliver the 1-2. And here's a pitch inside, and that got him.
Well, you never want the tying run on base, especially that way. Looked like he lost his release point, and the ball ran inside until it caught him. Now we'll see if he can work around it.
Tim LoCastro will come on now and pinch run here. Standing in now, Ketel Marte. And look out, he has to back away there and then give a little glare out to the mound. It's ball two. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch.
Three
and one.
He drilled the previous batter, and now he falls behind 3-1 to this guy. The last thing you can do, though, is throw a fastball middle of the plate right here.
LoCastro at second, Peralta at first with no outs. Full count, 3-2. Count remains full. And I don't think that's what he wanted to do, as the bases are loaded now with still nobody out.
That's a big no-no. He obviously had to work carefully with two men on, but he did not want to walk him to load the bases. Now he's really got his work cut out for him. We'll see how he fares here.
Stepping up now, Christian Walker, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Now the 2-1 is laid off of for ball number three.
What gotta love a late rally, and listen to this crowd now. They are really into this.
Pitch swung on and hit in the air toward the line and right. Catch is made near the line. Here comes the runner from third. Notch one in the score column as the runner from third crosses the plate.
Man, this is a spot where you really want to get greedy as a hitter. Bases loaded, nobody out. You're hoping for that big swing of the bat. What does he get? A sacrifice fly, and only one run scores. I'm sure he wanted more, but he's not going to complain about the RBI.
Jake Lamb standing in now. Not much in the way of productivity from him so far, but he's got a chance to come through here in a crucial spot.
Yeah, it's time now that he has to put the rest of those bats behind him, because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
One out with the possible tying and go-ahead runs on base here. Hit hard, back up the middle, and a weak
hits with the backhand, but he comes up empty as that gets by him. In the score, the runner from third. And he'll make it to third base safely with only one out as the go-ahead run.
Late inning problems have doomed this team all season. It's a hallmark of a losing club, not being able to hold a lead. And here's another example of the bullpen serving up the tying run here in the late innings.
Tyler Kinley takes the mound to try to get out of this mess. There are two on with only one away. Eduardo Escobar will be the first to greet him here as he'll do so with runners at the corners and only one out. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Fielded cleanly. There's one on to first. And talk about doing the job out of the bullpen. One batter, two outs, and the inning is over. So it's two runs on one hit, no errors, and one man left on. Ninth inning coming up, and we are all tied at three apiece. Tim LoCastro will stick around as he'll take over in right field. Here's Starlin Castro, 0 for 2 with a walk for him so far. The 1-1. Fouled off. The 1-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Well, we've seen some really good pitching from these guys in this one. The bullpen has looked sharp and have backed up a nice effort turned in by the starter. These days, pitching has become a full staff effort, and I've been impressed with the job these guys have done so far.
Hit hard to the right, and he lays out, but he can't make the play. We'll do it again. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. Bases are empty, one man out. Fouled away. The 2-2. Will not catch the zone, ball three.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher, but you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
Full count still. Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one. Fastball at the letters, and he turns on it, hits it high and deep out to center field. But he will haul this in on the run as he had to go back to the warning track to do it, and there are two away. Had a long way to go to make that running catch, and here it is again with the show track numbers. Took a great angle at it, showed nice closing speed, and ended up running close to 110 feet to finally bring it in. No doubt in efforts his teammates are appreciative of. Stepping in now, number 48. A ball and two strikes now. Bases are empty here with two men out. One 1-2 pitch is a slider that misses. 2-2. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full. Smoked on the ground up the middle. A diving try, but it's through into the outfield. Two, And I suspect we might see a pinch hitter here. And if that's the case, here's what's left on the Marlins bench. Neil Walker will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line. Now time is called, and we'll have a pinch runner at first, and that'll be a wise decision as he's the potential go-ahead run. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. Before the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. Throw is up the line as it gets away.
I think this one all comes down to poor footwork. The runner really didn't have that big of a lead by any means, so he was probably just simply throwing over there. It looks pretty easy, right? But when you're spinning to make that throw like that, this one just gets away from him, something he might need to work on before his next outing.
One and two. One and two. Here it is. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Marte has it in his tracks, makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. No runs on one base hit, one error in the inning, and a man left on. We're knotted up, headed to the bottom of the ninth as the Diamondbacks will try to walk it off in the desert. Magnaris Sierra will stay in the ballgame as he takes over in center. Arlene Garcia enters to do the pitching, and best case scenario for him is to push this one into extra innings. Stepping up to the plate, Carson Kelly. He started out the evening 0 for 2 so far. The 3-1. Right on it there, but this is foul over toward the first base dugout. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. The next 3-2. Takes this the other way to right, and it's a base hit. So there you go, the potential winning run aboard to start off the home half of the ninth. So he waited till the ninth inning, but he comes through here to extend the hit streak. That was close.
Yeah, Matty B, you see that wry smile of him coming out of the box right there. He knew what was on the line. He'd be lying if he didn't.
There's a lot of pressure on you because you're walking into that batter's box thinking, I have a nice streak going, and this is more than likely going to be my last AB. He comes through in the clutch.
A swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away.
I think he had his mind made up. He was swinging the bat and trying to protect before the ball even left the pitcher's hand. That pitch wasn't even close. He would have needed a flagpole to hit that one.
In now, Wilmer Flores. A ball and two strikes. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Now the 1-2 pitch. Good job going down and hanging with it that time. Possible winning run on first. One man away. And a slider just about gets away from him there as it runs in a bit too close for comfort. Here's the 2-2 pitch. This one's down to third. Bluffed by Castro. The second for one. Back to first. A double play. And we are heading to extra innings. Around the horn they go. 5-4-3 to end the threat. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this. Number 49 is ready, and he'll take the ball from the manager. Digging in to try it again. Number 47. He went deep earlier, and he's 2-for-4 to this point.
And that last at-bat when he went deep, he turned around a pretty good fastball. So I'm kind of thinking this guy's a good fastball hitter. So I might want to move that ball up and down and in and out and try not to throw it right down the middle of the plate.
Lamb will get under this one, and he's got it for the first down. Ready for another shot now, Miguel Rojas. Line to the right side. And that's into the outfield for a one-out base hit. And if you're wondering who's still available in the Arizona bullpen, there you go. We'll see if they think about playing the percentages here. Now time is called, and we'll have a pinch runner at first, and that'll be a wise decision as he's the potential go-ahead run. At the plate, Garrett Cooper is one away. The runner at first represents the potential go-ahead score. Double play is in order, however. And this one runs a little too far in, ball two. Now some action out in the bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander begin throwing. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Runner's going. Strike called, now the throw down. He's in there easily as the throw bounces on the way down. Here's the 2-2 pitch, and it's fouled away. Ready with another two-strike offering. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. And foul, though it had the home run distance. Ready with another two-strike offering. He swings at the fastball here and lifts it into the air to shallow center. There to take it in is Flores, and there are two away now.
Boy, he showed some pretty good range heading pretty deep into the outfield to bring that one down. Thought the outfielder might call him off, but he clearly had it under control.
Into the box, Jorge Alfaro. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2.
Now on 3-2 as a pitcher, you've got to go with the pitch that you feel most comfortable throwing with.
He's set the payoff pitch. Count still full, 3-2. And that misses, ball four. So it's first and second now with two out.
Just a nice piece of hitting right there, especially in extra innings. He didn't try to win the thing by himself or be a hero. He just patiently worked the at bat until he earned the walk. We'll see if his teammates can pick him up now.
Ready now, number one, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call.
A lot of times you see guys get too aggressive and try to do too much at the plate with guys on, but right here he's doing a great job of waiting on the right pitch. Got himself ahead in the count now.
popped him up. And he will indeed make the play in foul territory to retire the side. Marlins strand a pair. Score remains tied at 3-3. John Birdie will stay in the ballgame as a new shortstop. Set to get his evening at the plate started, Tim LoCastro. And it's been a real struggle for him with the bat so far this year, looking to get things turned around in a hurry. And this ball runs away for ball two, 2-1.
Sometimes it can be difficult for a pitcher. You're facing a guy that's not known to be a big stick in the lineup. Sometimes the toughest thing is to be aggressive and throw strikes.
3-1 now.
Well, that's ball three. The Diamondbacks right now would welcome a leadoff walk to start this inning.
The 3-1 is swung on and missed. A full count now.
I'll tell you, if I'm on the hill, I'm throwing that changeup again. Didn't look like he picked it up very well out of his hand.
Crowd gets up for the 3-2. And the winning run will reach. It's a leadoff walk to start the home half here in extra innings.
He's really struggled with his command in this game, no doubt about it. But to make things worse, he just lost one of the fastest guys in the ballpark.
Digging in once again, David Peralta. The winning run is at first base. And now a bunt attempt here as he gets this one down. But this will get foul. It's a ball and two strikes. Now the 1-2 pitch. Lifted the other way out to left center. Giving chase is Sierra. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning. Into the box now, Ketel Marte. He's got a chance to end this one and send these fans home happy if he can get a ball deep enough into the gap. The 1-1 pitch. And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now. Now the 2-1. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. Possible winning run on first, one man away. Runner goes for second. Still 2-2. Before the pitch, a check on that winning run at first. And he'll get back in safely. Ready with another two-strike offering. Softly hit down to third, likely no shot at two. Throw won't get him. Now at the plate, Christian Walker. The winning run at second, however, the double play in order here. The 3-1 pitch. Slap hard the opposite way, and that will get down out there. Throw coming quickly, and the winning run moves up to third now with only one gone.
Dan, right here you see a situation where no doubles defense comes back to bite you. As a pitcher, are you even aware when guys are playing a foot off the track?
I'll be honest with you, D-Ro. You're so concerned about on the mound trying to get that white ball to that dark brown or black glove that I never really ever turned around to even know it's where they were playing. I was concerned about getting the guy out swinging the bat.
Teron Guerrero is called upon to pitch, really needing that double play ball. Bases are loaded here with only one man out. Into the box now, Jake Lamb.
Swing and a fly ball. And that should be deep enough to end it. He'll make the catch, but it ought to be academic now. And the Diamondbacks are going to walk off winners.
That's what you call doing your job, folks. He knew he just needed to lift one to the outfield, and that's just what he did. Hey, a walk-off sack fly isn't as dramatic as a game-winning hit, but it's just as effective. Great team win right there.
It was mostly pitching and defense in this one, but the man you see here made some noise with the bat, and as a result, he's our top player of the game.
Well, when your one hit of the game is a home run and it ends up being a really critical one, you have to feel pretty good. It wasn't a huge day on the stat sheet, but it led his team to a win, and that's all you can hope for as a player.
And it's a 4-3 finish in this evening's ball game. Number 49 wins in relief for the eighth time this year. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney down on the field, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. Thanks for watching MLB Network.